Hello, everybody. Thanks for tuning in to HyperRPG, an independent live stream that's studio focused on. Malika's eating pizza right now, but you know what pizza is? Fun, fun, fun.
I was just eating a slice of pizza that was sent to us by you guys from
Trace. Oh, thank you.
Isn't that awesome?
That is amazing. I will be eating some pizza when I am done talking on here. That is, thank you so much.
And you are watching Rabbit Stew.
Oh. Hello, we're back. Well, I'm back. Malika's always been here. I'm back.
The awesome. Do I have like pizza lips on right now?
You have a little bit of something in your teeth. You might want to do a little. I'll cover for you. So this is Rabbit Stew. It's our daily update show, and today is Tuesday, which means it's time to talk about video games and board games. So we're gonna do reviews, interviews, hang out, talk about the latest news. I think Rabbit Stew is the coolest thing because we don't just talk about what we want to talk about. We talk about what you, the chat, wants to talk about.
Yeah, absolutely. All our news comes I think this should be here. All our news comes from the mods. So thank you for helping me put together the news. And
thank you, mods.
Not only do we talk about games, but we get to talk to to you guys about games. So I'm really excited.
Too.
So can I get a hello, what's up? I want to see
hello, everybody.
Who's hanging out in the chat room right now.
If you're in chat, give us a big, I don't know, hey, hey, hey.
Hey, 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 hey. Is that how you read that? Do you read the hey, hey, hey in a voice like hey, 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 hey?
There's some hey, creepy there. Voices that you could go with.
Could be like, hey, hey, hey there.
Yeah. Hey. Really high voice.
Hi. Hi, everybody. I love you all. Thanks for sending me the pizza earlier today. Hi.
Fantastic. Man, I see a lot of people I've been talking to on Discord hanging out tonight or today. That's awesome.
Oh, DJ Knight.
Hey.
Hey, nice to see you.
Hello.
I'm so glad you're going to be coming to our Necropolis event. If you haven't heard, on July 9th, we're doing a 12-hour stream to feature Necropolis. We invited a whole bunch of cool people like DJ Knight, like people like Man vs. Game, and to Sashka, and some of our great friends. Margaret Crone's coming. A lot of awesome people are coming. Some of the biggest streamers on Twitch and people from YouTube, Splattercat Games, Soulbrand, which is a team of Dark Souls streamers, they're all coming to team up and play Necropolis with us.
Necropolis party on, hype.
Yeah, it's called the Co-op Death Jam.
Basically a live stream party, right?
Yeah, basically a live stream party. We're giving one collector's edition away every hour. We're giving out signed prints. What? We're giving out Steam keys,
yes.
Art. It's gonna
all
be
all about the Steam keys.
Oh, Eki Tony, just thank you for resubscribing. Any positions Woo! Still available on the Yojimbo?
Woo! Thank you so much for resub 5 months in a row too.
Yes,
we
that
love
means
you
have been here from the beginning.
Oh, any position still available on the Yojimbo?
Oh, absolutely. We definitely always need more hands on deck.
So last week or 2 weeks ago, I was getting a reputation for giving out good positions. So now I feel like I have to live up to that.
You can give a good position.
Let's see here. Maybe
I think they need help in the escape pods.
Escape pods.
Escape pods.
Well, I can't think of a more important job than escape pod maintenance duty, because when the ship's going down, everybody's gonna hate you if you didn't make those escape pods work correctly.
Exactly.
So escape pod engineer.
Escape pod.
Eki 20, you are now officially the escape pod engineer.
Congratulations.
Wait, we have escape pods?
Well, how did we do our awesome live stream in New York City?
Eki 20.
And at ETX.
First, get us escape pods, then be the engineer of those escape pods.
Oh, Emily, thanks for resubscribing for 5 months.
Woo! Thank you, Emily. You're the best. Wow, 2 5 months in a row. That's 10 months of total subscribing.
Those are people who have been subscribing from the beginning.
Really?
Yeah. Math. Did you guys also watch us during our original charity stream?
I was here. It was my first experience
with
Twitch at all. It was quite an experience.
I'm curious, what did you think?
Of Twitch or of the charity stream?
Of the charity stream, of everything.
It was like all the things that I would do in college, but not live. Like, not live on video.
Like playing games with
like
other
playing
people?
Games and hanging out and
never
doing
going to sleep.
Dancing and never going to sleep. Yeah, it was. It was totally.
And helping kids.
And helping kids.
And
absolutely.
Helping kids.
Yeah.
It was
that
awesome.
Was really awesome. I loved it. It was a great first interaction with all things Hyper RPG.
Speaking of interacting with all things Hyper RPG, just a reminder, we're on Twitter, Hyper_RPG,
yes.
And on Facebook, just Hyper RPG, and then we also have a community-run subreddit. Thank you for participating in all the conversations. Whoa, Josephine, thanks for subscribing, you're awesome!
Thank you so much, woo! Josephine! Another 5 months. 15 months of subscribing.
So you just add. This is like I like the way that you're adding all the months of everybody subscribing.
Yeah.
I mean, that's enough for like here and to the future.
Yeah,
right?
Totally.
Hopefully.
It means they believe in us for the future.
Oh, that's a good. That's
we
good.
Appreciate you.
I like how MTL Snowman said, when Claudia finally crashes the Yojimbo, the escape pod will be our only hope. Yeah. Well, actually, they reached their follower goal, so...
1,000.
Yeah. Well, so that was... We
oh,
reached
that was
our subscriber goal.
Yes.
And our follower goal, which means that Zach and Claudia are going to take a tandem bike ride together.
Yes. Yes.
Hey, Aerodazic. Nice to see you. Nice
and
to see you.
And we will, of course, video said tandem bike ride, right?
Yes, of
all
course.
Right.
I mean, no, they're just going to, like, go off into the woods
well,
by themselves.
Well, you know, I just want to make sure that we get...
Awkward.
We get evidence.
Okay. Osborne didn't even plan it, but I couldn't resist to be subscriber number 100.
Woo!
Wow. Lucky number.
Wow, yeah. Osborne, what's your title? What's your role?
I don't know. I don't think we were doing it back then, but definitely will give you the opportunity.
All right.
On your resub anniversary.
Sounds great. So what other announcements we have here?
So, as you know, we have our awesome fan pack.
Yes.
And I will do this. I'm so sorry, guys. I will do this before I go to sleep tonight. I've been sick. I will give you a transparent PNG version of the logo as well so that you can put it on any color. Yeah.
I love it. Then I can just put it on like the corner of like my Facebook
mm-hmm,
or something
mm-hmm,
like that. Fantastic.
Yep. And just so you know, somebody did write something. This is the collector's edition I was just talking about. So it's done with I Am 8-Bit. And check this out. You will be the coolest kid in town.
Tell me about it. Because I'm a sucker for collector's editions.
Are you a sucker for vinyl? Yeah,
what?
That's right.
Vinyl. I love vinyl.
Vinyl.
Are you kidding
vinyl.
Me?
Vinyl. Check this out. It's teal.
So is this the soundtrack?
Yes, it's the soundtrack on vinyl.
What?
It's only $50, and it includes the game as well. So it's actually a really good deal.
Malika doesn't even know that I collect vinyl.
Well, I collect vinyl as well. And it comes with this awesome death certificate. And
wait. Explain the death certificate.
Okay,
to me.
So Necropolis is a
You're
game
dead.
Of death with friends.
Okay.
It's a cooperative game, and it's very punishing. There's permadeath, and it's a procedural game. So every time you die, the necropolis like rebuilds
itself.
Completely
different.
Exactly.
Yep. Okay.
And then you might die again and again and again.
Again. I got it.
But
since you're already dead, it's okay.
So you lose everything except for the things that you buy with tokens of favor.
Oh.
So all your gems, all your cool weapon drops, armor. Bye-bye.
Wow.
It's a pretty tough game.
Very existential game.
Well, you know, that's why it's going to be a lot of fun on
yeah.
July 9th, because we're going to see some of the most interesting, varied, variety, Dark Souls, you know, rogue-like and rogue-lite
yeah,
enthusiasts play this kind of game.
It seems like you have a wide variety of styles of streamers coming.
Yes,
so.
And we actually have Brazenhead... trophies being made by a props guy, and they light up and the eye lights up, and then all the it's gonna be so awesome.
Oh,
yeah.
Yes,
it's pretty awesome.
But for me, I want the vinyl.
You want the vinyl?
I want the vinyl.
Well, do you know they also made a tabletop game? Did you see this? So it's
what?
A vinyl and it like folds open, so the vinyl is inside there. It comes with a death certificate and it comes with a game.
What?
Yeah, and then I. Let's see if we can...
Like, tabletop as in board or RPG?
Like, check this out. I'm just going to zoom in so that you can see a little bit better here.
Okay.
But you can see that there's like these little creatures, and then there's it's a map with a little dot, and then there's some instructions about
this
how you can go
so
around.
This is so cool.
And then there's some hit points, and it's basically like...
People without the collector's edition are going to be sad.
Well, there's a chance to win it for free on July 9th.
All right, show up on July 9th and win free collector's edition.
Absolutely, amongst other things.
All right.
Osborne said you definitely didn't do it back then. It was before this charity stream.
Yeah.
I would say you definitely have an opportunity to enlist.
Enlist. I think with a resub, you definitely immediately
Absolutely.
Get a title.
Sure.
That's how it's got to work.
All right. So we have a very special guest today.
Okay.
Do you know?
Cassidy Werner?
Yes.
Is that who we're talking
about? Yes, that's what we're talking
about. Oh my gosh. So Cassidy, you guys are going to love her. She's from Cheap Ass Games.
And she's a sweetie pie.
She
Can
is
I say
a
that?
Sweetie
she
pie.
She's the sweetest. She actually, speaking of the charity stream,
yes.
gave us like $200 worth of stuff to
yeah, she
give
donated
away
a ton of stuff.
During the charity stream just to help the kids. So
yes.
a real sweetie pie.
So at that time she worked at Calliope Games,
yeah,
which makes all kinds of great family games. Mm-hmm. She recently moved positions to work at Cheap Ass Games to help them with their amazing TAC Kickstarter.
Yes, it's beautiful.
Yes.
That's the subtitle. It's like TAC, a beautiful game.
It is literally called TAC, a beautiful game.
And I definitely want to ask her about how that was made, because there are different versions of the board.
Well, and it's so
more
cool.
More and more beautiful.
Exactly, and it's based off a game in a book. Mm-hmm. So the parts about the game were already written about in the book, and then they had to figure out...
Like, okay, what's this game?
What the heck is this game?
Yeah, so that's definitely going to be an interesting challenge.
Yeah, it's going to be really interesting to hear about that. So I'm excited about that, and...
Also, at 3 p.m., there is a new episode
Do not miss this episode of Grab Bag. Do not miss it.
So we have a lot of exciting things happening on this episode of Grab Bag. I wanted to shake things up. I love inviting all the guest game devs that come on every week. But, you know, let me just show you the kinds of things I'm talking about. So on Twitter, if you see it right here, vote for the theme and watch game dev press some skin to make a new game. Where are my options? It's just not loading. Do you see this?
Oh, there it is.
There it is. I'm going to drag it over here.
All right.
So we could be holding hands, handshakes, hugs, or fist bumps. This is something that, you know, we'll have to inspire the game that is being created at 3 p.m. today.
Specific time. I expect bodily contact.
Well, they all have bodily contact.
Don't miss it.
You can vote as Zach. So let's take his vote away. What do you
want? Arl Binky, I want book 3 now as well. Agreed. Sorry. Go on.
Absolutely. What would you like to vote for, Patrick? They're all pretty awesome. I really like hugs. Holding hands.
There's something to be said
funny.
About holding hands, especially if, let's say, you were forced to hold hands while you were making the game or something.
Sure.
Although I've always kind of been a fist bump fan as well.
Fist bumps.
Let's do fist bumps.
Fist bumps. All right. We're going to vote. Let's see what's winning. Oh, hugs and fist bumps are like neck and neck. This is one of the closest grab bags that we've ever had. So, guys, make sure you get your vote in, because if you want hugs and fist bumps wins, well, I'm sorry. You can't complain because you didn't vote.
Yes.
Commander Dunsail voted for handshakes because they creep kids out these days. it's so funny. The handshakes only got 6%, and that's like the most polite.
Yeah, it is
one,
the most polite.
Right? Holding hands is pretty.
Handshakes,
pretty
I've noticed, especially a lot of conventions because of con crud.
Sure.
Nobody shakes
hands. No handshakes.
It's all about the fist bump now.
Fist bumps?
Yeah.
I've like bumped elbows. Is that lame?
Oh, yeah, they do. That's.
I'm sick. Like,
I think they started that at PAX. Yeah.
All right. Okay. Kato-kun is a friend computer and is actually my real friend from middle school, high school. Thanks for watching.
What?
I really appreciate it.
That's amazing.
Yeah, he also streams sometimes. You should go over there and bug him.
Absolutely.
He likes to stream Destiny.
Oh.
Yeah, and he's a photographer. And
a good game. locally made.
And he went to school in Maryland.
Oh, he's my man. All right.
Hi.
Hello. Everybody, how do you know all this about every single person, Malika?
Well, this is like a real life friend. Meet space.
Okay,
like
got
real
it.
Real life friend. So, everybody, make sure all our new followers and subscribers and lurkers feel nice and warm and welcome. And can we give a thank you to the mods?
Are you sure, Phoenix, the fist bumps don't exchange germs? They're still like contact.
No, they're totally. Right. That's like. But that's like 5 second rule.
All
it's
right.
Like,
oh,
oh
yeah.
Like
it's
less, you know, right. Germ. Right. I think that deserves a fist bump.
Fist bump.
Blow it up?
I kind of do because my son really likes to
okay,
do that.
All right.
So I've gotten used to it. But I, oh, then I left it
hanging. Okay.
Well, it started right. With, of course, Big Hero 6.
Oh, yeah. I so. Love, there was a GIF actually on Twitter now you can use. They're just like doing the fist bump over and over again. I love it.
That's
I love
fantastic.
It. Chest bump. That's a, that would have been a
wow,
good idea.
Wow, that would have.
Yeah, maybe like that would have been better than handshakes. Maybe next week. That will be an option. Trust me.
Right.
Like,
ugh. All
right. So, and we have a very special event tonight at 6 p.m. We're going to be playing Tokyo Mirage Sessions with Claudia.
You always play the best games on Tuesday nights.
Oh, well, Claudia's going to be all over this one. Just watch this.
Whoa.
Can you tell?
I think there might be anime in this. I watched the Rabbit Stew that she was talking about this. Yes.
Oh, this is super cute. Oh my goodness. Oh no! It's like evil!
Wormhole. Everybody was so happy and
oh,
so.
Oh! C9 Phoenix, thanks for following! You're Woo! A great computer! The animation's beautiful.
It is. It's cell shaded, I think, but not. Very good. I can't really watch this video without thinking about when Claudia was talking about this video, how
yeah.
excited she was.
Yeah, she's gonna be so excited.
She was melting.
You definitely want to see her play this game tonight. And one thing is, there's gonna be singing tonight.
There's gonna be what?
There's gonna be singing.
Oh, yeah. So
yes.
She's going to be singing as well.
So, as you know, Zach hates singing, happiness, love, and hearts. And we're going to be singing tonight. I mean, I'm not going to be there. Well, maybe I could be there. I don't know.
Is Zach going to be singing?
Zach? Well, Zach loves to sing.
Okay.
But he hates musicals. And they're going to be singing 90s boy band classic hits.
Okay.
So you definitely want to watch because
yes.
you can vote on what Backstreet Boys, NSYNC song,
yes.
whatever that they're going to cover for you tonight. and I think it's going to be a lot of fun.
Yes. I think that boy bands, is Joe singing as well?
I think we have to. Joe has to sing.
Like,
Joe
we are,
Joe was supposed to be in a boy band.
We almost have a boy band.
He kind of is.
Yeah.
Right.
Like, he's kind of the gruff one that all the girls... Yeah, Joe.
Joe is the gruff one?
He can kind of... Yeah, I think he could be the gruff one.
I think Zach's like the serious one.
Zach is the serious one, but he's the serious, like, hey guys, it's all about business one. Joe's like the loner of the
band. Loner.
Yes.
Do you really think so?
I think...
what does that make Ryan?
Within the boy band. Oh, come on. Ryan's like the woo, hype machine. That's what Ryan is. Ryan's like, I'm in a boy band. All right.
Chat room, I'd love to hear your opinion about which one of the dudes of Hyper RPG fits some kind of boy band stereotype.
Yeah, I would love
I
to
like
hear
rules
that.
I like Rules of Rules, says Joe and the two,
Joe
white,
and two
dudes,
white dudes.
Right? That's the name of the band, Joe and the two white dudes.
Yes.
Oh my God! What the fuck, you
yeah,
guys
he
missed
is Leo, yeah.
a golden opportunity to form a full band with Kirby. I know. Yesterday was Kirby's last day.
I know, and I most people in chat don't know this, but I've been friends with Kirby
yeah.
for a long time.
Yeah, you brought us Kirby, didn't
yeah,
you?
Yeah. So Kirby.
Patrick brought us Kirby, brought us Joe. Patrick, can you fill out our boy band, please?
I'll see what I can do. But it's really sad for me for Kirby to be leaving. We've been friends for so long.
Draconius is Rai is the sweet piper. Joe and the forgettable faces.
So
it should just be like Joe and the forgettable faces.
Oh, man.
So
Joe and those other guys.
There's some awesome fan art coming out of you guys. We're gonna take a look at it right now. So I heard there is some shipping of Shadowrun characters.
Oh, I didn't realize this is like our fans.
Yeah,
fan art.
our fans of our shows. I know, isn't this awesome? The big ship, you're one dynamite gal. Oh my goodness, it's it's Mainframe and Mordecai. That's pretty cute. It's right in the eyes. Look at the eyes.
Yeah.
He's just like.
I like that inking style too. It's really
cool.
Yeah,
it's awesome.
It actually kind of looks like classic Shadowrun art if you were to go.
Yeah,
like
for sure. For sure. It definitely fits in the theme. Oh, look, it's a heart. All right. Awesome. And then we got a lot more other stuff. What is this? This is the first time I'm seeing this stuff, guys. Awesome. Oh! Hey! It is DFA!
Yes,
that's so cool!
Sick.
Oh, man.
That's awesome.
They look awesome.
I was telling all my friends back in Baltimore about Death from Above, and they were freaking out.
Really?
Yeah, they're really
they
excited.
Be
oh, yeah, totally. They're really excited. They're like giant mechs, and you destroy the mechs.
Absolutely.
Yeah, they're super excited.
Did you know that tradition started at Gen Con?
No.
Yeah, so Jordan Wiseman used to just destroy mechs
at Gen Con,
and it was like kind of a show thing.
That's awesome.
And we're like,
that
why don't
like
we
a
make
idea.
A show out of it?
Yeah.
And that's how that started, guys.
It's so good.
A little history lesson for you. But this is awesome. They look so badass, and I love the take on, this is like...
Hi, Toad Coder!
Another version of the DFA logo. It's really cool.
Yeah.
I love skulls. Love skulls. All right, what is this? Also on the Twitters, guys, please keep tweeting us this fan art. It's awesome.
Seriously, this is so good.
All right. Oh, nice.
What?
Talon. Oh, this is awesome. Wow.
That's
look
a,
at the detail. That is a really, yeah, this is a really strong, profile.
Yeah.
Definitely somebody who understands some anatomy, too.
Almost has like a, there's another RPG, Feng Shui, that is awesome. Kind of reminds me of that art style.
No, it's really cool, and I like how there's some text in the middle and stuff. Talfi. So this is shipping. Wow. There's a lot of love in the air.
There's a lot of love in the air.
There's a lot of
RPGs.
Okay, and all aboard the USS Alrida. Alrida. I can't speak today. Oh, awesome. We got some gifts here. Yes, that's me. Mrs. Nebraska. Oh my gosh. There is so much love. You know,
I think it's
warming up around here in Seattle, right?
Love is in the hair.
Love is in the hair. Wow, that is awesome. All right, I'm going to check this one out,
yes,
too.
Yes, a show dedicated to shipping. That could be like the early morning show.
It is shipping on the ship.
shipping on the ocean.
Oh,
motion.
Check this out. She's been working on this for a
what?
While.
No
this
way.
This is our Hyper RPG Rabbit.
Yeah, absolutely.
And even like the
yeah,
little
got the
angle.
Legs, right, and everything.
Yeah,
that's
really awesome. Wow.
That is so cool.
Please, 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 if you could make the pattern downloadable, I would attempt that. That's awesome. Isn't that awesome?
It is really, really cool.
It's really cool. And have you seen this surprise from the Shadowrun cast? Check this out.
Woo! Woo!
Oh, that's awesome.
Oh no.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, that's so good. Hey, I know that part. I love it.
Oh my gosh, this is so fun.
I bet he is. I'm sure that was not a cool day. This is the ultimate shipping right here.
This is so cute. Where did they shoot this? Like just around here?
I think it's Marymore Park.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Oh, Parky.
Love it. Yay!
So, if you want to see more of Farky, make sure to tune in to Shadowrun.
That was perfect.
I saw a few questions in the chat room. Do you have some quiz time, Malika? What's the Thumper's name?
Oh.
I think the rabbit is just Thumper.
Thumper is a name, I guess.
Yeah, it's Thumper's name,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, Thumper's name is Thumper.
Thumper.
All right.
And then Gaycast asked, Malika, do you have a link for that? Link, please. What are we asking for? A link for our Shadowrun video?
Oh, yeah, maybe the video you just showed.
Okay. It looks like... Okay, you linked it in the chat room. Thank you very much. Joe, doing the awesome job.
Great.
Awesome. Oh yeah, because there's only one view.
Those videos are so great for showing people too what HyperRPG is all about.
Absolutely, it's about.
It's about.
It's about love. It's about love, guys.
It's about.
Yeah.
The fans causing beautiful love.
So, we are. Oh my goodness! So that was a bunch of fan art and.
Yes, thank you. Fan art is so awesome.
Oh. So I see a little announcement here from you.
Oh yeah, well it's not really an announcement, but
yeah,
I just wanted
like
to.
An announcement.
Yeah, well, so yesterday Steam sale hype.
Steam
right?
sale.
I'm sure. Oh my god, we have other things to talk about for Steam sale. So, but yesterday I finally pulled the trigger and picked up the Tabletop Simulator.
Okay.
Yes,
that's awesome. And I'm surprised that you don't have that already.
I know. Well, I almost there's a story. Right. I almost bought it last Steam sale, yeah. And then it like. Came off before right. I thought it was gonna come off,
right.
And I was like,
Steam sales, you gotta jump on them.
I know. So, anyways, I bought it right away. But also now with HyperRPG, I thought this is an amazing way for me to play board games with everybody. Like,
oh yeah,
chat and Discord
so
everything.
Yeah, for definitely in Discord, and also we have a Steam group. I think the fans created it.
Okay.
So you could totally play with everybody on Steam.
Yes. So I want to play board games with you, with the audience, and with other people from Discord.
Yeah,
so.
Absolutely. I would be like a little intimidated if I hadn't already played games with you before.
Don't be intimidated. I wanna play.
I think you're bad at bluffing.
I'm pretty bad at bluffing. You know what? I'm bad at. I even look like I'm bluffing when I'm not bluffing.
It's okay. I'm bad with numbers.
I'm bad at lying.
Which is bad for a lot of tabletop games.
But I definitely want to play some board games with everybody from HyperRPG.
Oh, speaking of Summer Steam Sale, it's not in our little notes here, but I just wanted to pull it up.
Yes.
There is now a Shadowrun.
The other one I was
Complete.
Shadowrun, complete collection.
Collection, 80% off. So basically, get all the things. Check this out, all the things. This is like the first time.
How do you not buy that at that point?
So yeah, it's like $14.75, and you get all the HBS Shadowrun games.
I don't even know how many hours of content that is, but that's a lot of content.
A lot. But also, as you notice, they're deluxe. They are the deluxe edition, which means that you get the soundtrack and the art books.
Oh, so I didn't even know that.
If you have, and one thing that's really cool about this pack is, oh, say you have. You know, the Shadowrun triple pack, or you already have these games, but you didn't get the deluxe edition, you can still get kind of the rest.
Got it.
80% off. So
that
it's
would
like,
actually be
see,
me.
That's why it's only $1.99.
Yeah,
and you can pick up
all
the parts.
I'm missing some of that stuff.
So that's why they're going it with the complete collection, because it is everything, and you can also complete your collection.
Gosh,
see?
So good.
See?
I have so many friends that worked on these games too and like poured their heart into them.
Absolutely. And this is only going until I think July 4th. So you only have a little bit of time left. So definitely check it out,
guys. Don't
be
like me and wait till the last minute, because I honestly thought last time the Steam sale would end at Pacific time. And for whatever reason, it ended at East Coast time or something.
I think
I was too late.
I know sales go up 10 a.m. on Steam Pacific time.
Yeah, so don't miss it this time. Get Tabletop Simulator and get the Shadowrun.
Awesome.
Run.
Some people are like, oh, I only need Hong Kong to complete my collection. It's
exactly.
A good deal. Yeah, so it's great.
And
Hong also,
Kong is
an
the
awesome
best.
Gift.
Yes.
I might say so myself.
That's true.
I ship between RPG shows. You do not want to know who I match.
Uh-oh.
You know what? I think the more the merrier. So if you're shipping somebody from the Shadowrun show and the Valiant show.
Oh, that's the way to go.
That's like awesome.
That is awesome. That is
some transmedia storytelling.
That is the fan art we need.
Yeah, exactly. Yes. So go right ahead. You know what? If you want to write fan fiction, make gifts.
By the way, while I was in Maryland, I used that time to read some Valiant. I am now on the Valiant hype train.
Did you watch the show last night?
I haven't watched. I've watched the two shows before last night.
Right, so you have to catch them on VOD. Yep. It's getting better and better. It's really, really exciting. I know Zach
that
is
universe
personally
excited.
Very proud of his GM.
He should be. He really should be. Because it was his first time doing GMing, right?
Yep. So and then he just like does it on the internet for all you guys. So
yes.
Make sure you show him
no
some
pressure.
Love. Yep, no pressure. So you're going to tell me about a game designer,
yeah.
Right?
So we're going to do a game designer profile. And last week we did video game. Who did you do last week, by the way? I was
Last week I featured, or I talked about Jose Sanchez, who is an architect game designer.
Whoa.
An architect game designer. Yeah.
Because I love architects.
And, well, we could always feature more. I'm really into these game designers who are also something else.
Yeah, yeah.
They bring that something else to their game design.
Absolutely.
Right? So, real quick, Jose Sanchez, he's a professor of architecture at USC, and he's also a games lecturer at USC. And what he does, he's all about modular geometry. His first assignment in architecture class is to make his architecture students play Minecraft. Because it's about building,
right? Of course, yeah.
So he makes all sorts of really cool, like, 3D geometry, and he gamifies solving problems. So, like, building a structure to desalinate water.
How old is he? Like, what, like, age range is he?
He's, like, professor age range.
I'm just, like, considering what it must be like professor age range.
No, it's, like, I'm, like, student age range.
Can you imagine what it's like to kind of be an architect pre-digital revolution and then post-digital revolution?
He's young-ish.
Like, I have ideas and now I can make them. Like,
he's young-ish.
Young-ish.
Young-ish. Okay. Like less than 50.
Got it.
Okay.
So.
Oh, Corosite, thanks for resubscribing.
Thank you for the resub. Corosite,
thank you so much.
You are the best.
You are the bomb.
I'm working on my resub hype because
I just said you are the bomb. Is that still cool?
It's,
I'm getting old.
It's
I'm showing
cool
my age now.
It's not professor
it's
age.
Okay.
Talk, but you know, so
I'm sorry. Well, you're kind of professor.
I am professor.
That's like the nice way of saying you're old enough to have gotten graduate degrees,
it is,
but you might be smart.
It is a little weird going back home to Baltimore and being like, wow, we've all like gotten old. It's kind of crazy.
Now you could all be professors.
Yeah. In fact, some are.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So, anyways, game designer profile. We're going to talk about Jonathan Tweet. I just kind of, Jonathan didn't even know I was going to do this, but pulled his name out for today. Jonathan is awesome. He is one of my favorite designers locally to hang out with. He started all the way back. He's done a lot of stuff, but most notably, Ars Magica was one of his first RPGs, which maybe you've never heard of it. It was done with him and Mark Rainhagen. But what's cool about Ars Magica is it allows you, because you are all wizards.
Oh, okay. I love magic.
Yes, everybody's a wizard. Forget like the warrior. Everybody's a wizard.
Male and female wizards?
Male and female.
Awesome.
Oh, yeah.
I like that.
But unlike, say, D&D, where somebody's written down like what a spell does.
Yeah.
You get to actively, while you're playing the game, like design spells and make them happen.
Yeah.
So you can be really creative.
Oh, that sounds like a lot of fun.
Spellcaster.
It sounds like also fantasy, like power fantasy. Yes, I make all the magic.
Yeah, well, you're limited by your stats, what you can do, right?
But maybe you can level up.
Yeah, you level up, you become more powerful, like more you can fun. Be really creative in your magic. It's super cool. So yes, Ars Magica inspired Mage. In fact, the people, there are characters in Ars Magica that are the, I am blanking for a second. One of the Sons of Hermes, they are from Ars Magica and they're also in Mage.
Oh.
So if you've played Mage as well, you probably know about Ars Magica.
Let's Adapt says, I'm aware of Ars, but never played it.
Yeah, so then he went on to work, he did a lot of freelance work for TSR in the, who owned Dungeons & Dragons, Dungeons & Dragons, and continued with them.
He worked on D&D 3rd Edition.
On staff, and ultimately became lead designer,
developer
of Dungeons & Dragons 3rd Edition.
Wow.
So.
And I also saw that one of the things that he really cares about is having a lot of people of color and male and female characters
absolutely.
To play,
in fact, even if you were to look, there's a huge contrast between, say, 2nd Edition D&D and 3rd Edition D&D for diversity, and a lot of that is because of Jonathan.
Oh, that's so awesome. awesome.
So yeah, he had a lot of that input.
And he's making a kids game, or it's a second edition, right?
Kids game? No, that's Monte Cook.
No. The fish and grandma.
Oh, that is not a game at all. So you were talking about Cross. Yeah. So also, most recently, he wrote a book, a children's book, that is called Grandmother Fish.
I think if you go to his website.
And it's actually the first children's book, as far as he knows, that basically deals with evolution and explains evolution to children.
Oh, that's interesting.
So it's really awesome. And he kickstarted it, got it self-published, and it sold out immediately. Also, Gaia, CA, Mage hype. Mage is my game.
Mage.
I love Mage. I will talk about Mage all day, but.
Mage hype's for real.
Yes. All right. So Grandmother Fish.
That's so cool.
Yeah, it's really, really awesome.
Yeah.
But sold out immediately, and now it's being republished because.
Oh, yeah. Awesome. Because it did so
like,
well.
I forget which publisher, but actual.
Yeah, no. I saw that too. It was
McMillan.
McMillan.
Right. That sounds
yes.
right.
Yes.
And then his latest RPG is 13.
Yeah, McMillan.
McMillan, yeah, which is like a big, big publisher.
Yeah, that's
right?
Like huge.
Yeah,
he's gonna be in like every bookstore ever.
Oh my gosh, I will totally do Mage for charity stream. All right,
Mage for
you can put me on quote for that.
Oh my god, these are my people.
Yes.
Awesome.
All right. So one other thing to mention is his latest RPG is 13th Age.
Yeah, 13th Age.
And here's what I like about 13th Age: when you create a character, you get to choose one thing about that character that is like unique and special and awesome.
Sure. Like, for example?
Well, you could just be like, well, I am literally the strongest person in the entire world.
Okay.
That's a real simple one.
That's awesome.
And you would be, okay?
Oh.
Or you could say,
can I be the prettiest?
What?
Can I be the prettiest?
You can be the prettiest person. Well, whatever it is. But it could be anything you want. And one of the most creative uses I saw was somebody who said on their character sheet, I have never seen the sunlight.
Oh.
My character has never seen the sunlight. Which meant that before the game started, the game master then had to figure out what this world was.
Yeah.
Where a character has never seen the sunlight. So it can you can actually affect the world even in your character creation. And then the game master actually has to kind of.
That's interesting.
Yes. It's
that,
so
that sounds
good.
Like a lot of fun.
It's
that sounds like
so
really
point
great.
Being, Jonathan's really creative. He has taken kind of the building blocks of role playing and then gotten really creative and blown them up into new ways of playing games that now we take for granted. Like that role playing isn't just about running around and killing monsters, but it's about storytelling. Jonathan was a big part of that idea.
That's awesome.
So, yeah. So that is our developer highlight
for today. Oh yeah, we have this book out there.
Oh,
we give
awesome.
It away sometimes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Pellegrin is fantastic.
Just a
great
reminder, if you need to know why you should subscribe, is we do some awesome giveaways on this channel. All right. So we have a lot of new games that have come out, but there is one that I'm sure everybody is talking about, which is LEGO Star Wars.
We are. It's been established. I don't need to talk about my fandom for LEGO Star Wars.
LEGO Star Wars, The Force Awakens.
Oh my god, Chewie!
Yes!
Was that Chewie and Phantasma? Like.
Dastardly villains, droids, LEGO bricks, and heart.
Oh, that's is that C-3PO and Reen? What's going on?
Strap in for epic dogfights across the galaxy. Evade TIE fighters through the derelict ruins of Jakku. Save your friends on Takodana. And battle massive star destroyers.
Awesome.
I'm accustomed to such excitements.
Blaster battles put you right in the thick of the action. Dodge incoming enemy fire. And
yes.
Oh, no.
Right, strike back. Multi-builds offer unique ways to solve puzzles and engage enemies.
Oh, wow.
Will you build a subterranean
what
spider
is that?
Drone?
Yeah, it's like puzzles and stuff.
For a
it's like,
of a
yeah.
Flavor.
I have to tell you something, Malika. I've been playing so much X-Wing lately that I'm kind of rooting for the Imperials First Order.
Really?
Well, you know, like, I've started to turn to the dark side a little bit.
So you're really a Sith Lord?
I wouldn't go that far yet. But I do like those Imperials.
Lord Santeca and more.
What?
Jedi, there can be no balance in the Force.
Excellent. Oh, that's unfortunate.
Oh, no. Oh.
Yes.
Nothing gets you closer to the galaxy's greatest adventure than Lego Star Wars.
So good.
The Force Awakens.
Bye, Phasma. I love the new Star Wars so much.
We ordered the deluxe edition to receive early access to the Empire Strikes Back character pack.
I don't know about you, Malika, but I was so scared, like, the day before the new Star Wars came out. Just like,
why? Why were you
scared? Because what if it wasn't good?
What if it was bad?
What if it was bad? Like,
there have been bad things.
Yeah, and I really was scared, and it's so good, and I'm so happy. I am just dancing all this whole year. I am literally just in a happy mood because Star Wars was good.
Yeah, Star Wars was great.
Yes.
Absolutely. And it seems like more good Star Wars.
I know. Oh my gosh. I'm so excited about Rogue One.
Absolutely.
That looks amazing.
I'm actually really, like, from this trailer, I'm really excited because there seems to be a lot of story in the new
Star Wars. Yeah, it looks like maybe we'll even, because I know, for example, there was a snow speeder chase that was cut out of the film.
Oh, so maybe it'll be in this game. Yeah, it's out today, guys. Awesome. I'm wondering if anybody in the chat room is already playing it or is planning to later today or this week. Toadcoder says there's one thing that really irked me about the new movie. Stormtrooper helmets not filtering out.
What is that? Because I'm pretty sure in Clone Wars they do. So
yeah, that's a good point.
Their equipment's getting worse, not better.
Yeah, well, you know, the Empire, you know, they had a major setback.
Yes.
Yeah, maybe that's why. I don't know, guys.
I don't know either.
I don't make up these things. I love the new Star Wars, even with the quirks. I think that's Joe. Is that Joe? I also know that Zach was crazy about the new Star Wars.
Yeah,
he was so happy.
We have more Star Wars stuff to talk about.
Watched it in the theater like 3 times in a row.
Yeah, I saw it 3 times as well. And once with my son, which was really fun to like take your son to like his first Star Wars movie.
I think we need to move on. Another game that is out today is, all right, I just want to show a little love for people with a PS Vita.
Okay.
Because in my game designery, game developery opinion, the PS Vita is an awesome piece of hardware, and it's a shame that not more hit games are on that system.
That's actually how I felt about, I had the PSP.
Yeah.
I was actually in Africa during the PS Vita launch. So I kind of missed it, but
do you like your PSP?
I love my PSP. Yeah. I still play my PSP.
They make really good, like, it's a shame that the handheld stuff from Sony hasn't really taken off because it's designed so well.
Yeah.
And if you guys actually develop in Unity, it's very easy to port your games to the PSP. And it would have, you know, it seems like, there's like, it's easy to port them from Unity.
Yeah.
There are people who are making it, but just not enough people have a PS Vita. So.
Well, one of the things I just love about my PSP is I could have games downloaded on my PS3, PS4, like some of the games, and then also be playing them on my PSP.
Yeah.
And you can even like, yeah, so it feels like I'm getting more bang for my buck when I buy a game and it's on multiple consoles.
Right. So, this game was out like 5 months ago, and surprise, surprise, it's on the PS Vita now, if you're in the United States. It's been on the PS Vita since it was released in Japan, but now, surprise, surprise, you can get it on your PS Vita in the US,
awesome.
Too. This is like the kind of stuff that makes me like almost want to like buy a console, just saying. I mean, it's Final Fantasy. I'm like such a sucker, but all right. That's a thing. So, have you heard about this story about Activision pulling Orion from Steam? So, there's this shooter. Guys, there's this shooter. It's called Orion.
Okay.
And you shoot dinosaurs.
Okay.
It's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And this was pulled from... Yeah, but they're dinosaurs. They're prehistoric creatures. They've already gone extinct. They're virtual.
I like dinosaurs.
I like dinosaurs, too. We actually featured another awesome dinosaur game. It was kind of like Jurassic Park meets a strong female playable character.
Really?
Yeah, last week. So I'm excited about that.
While you were doing that, I was walking around the Smithsonian looking at dinosaur bones.
The more you know. So what's interesting here is Activision claims that Orion stole weapons from Call of Duty.
Weapons?
And, yeah, so...
They're upset about the weapons?
Yes.
But all the weapons in all these games are... pretty much generic.
So I'm going to pull up, I want you guys' opinion from the chat room here. So they said they stole weapons from Call of Duty Black Ops and Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. And if you look right here, so this is Black Ops. This is the gun.
Okay.
Right? And to me, like, all guns look the same. I don't care.
Yeah.
I know there are gun people out there. And this is the Orion gun. And I'm like, I don't know if I see it. It's like...
Well, Call of Duty stole right? that game from Rainbow Six, so...
Anyways, and then, all right. And,
like,
and
what?
Look at some of this Orion look-alike. Note the direct copy of the top section. So they're saying that this, you see with the light part here
okay,
and the
okay.
circle. They're saying that, you know, well, I don't know. This is...
Wait, is that M8A7, right are that is that like an actual gun?
Yeah.
So if that's an actual gun that like physically exists.
That's true. That's
and then
true.
They both look similar, I don't understand.
Yeah.
I don't
if
understand.
If they're all based off of real guns.
Your gun looks yeah. as realistic as our
says,
gun.
It
We're
looks
angry.
Like a gun. People are saying it's totally a different gun. So unfortunately, small indie studio gets picked on by big guys, right?
Yeah.
I don't know whether or not this theft is true, but basically they won the game.
Oh, it doesn't actually exist.
Okay, so it doesn't actually exist.
Need my brother-in-law, okay. Marine, in here to like give us.
Yeah, we need like a gun expert. Actually, there are a few veterans in our community.
Oh, awesome! Yeah.
Maybe you should answer these gun questions because I'm clueless.
Any of them are watching, please.
But. Yeah, I don't, it looks, you know, it looks different to me, and the founder of the studio said, you know, it has really hurt us because they're wrongly defaming us and slandering us,
yeah.
and it was only being sold for 99 cents on Steam.
Got it.
And then when it was on sale, it was on 49 cents. And so it's like, I don't know.
You guys are really...
I don't know. But, like, it is wrong to pull models from another game, like, regardless. So,
oh,
I don't
good.
Know.
Barui. Is that how you say that? Bowery?
Yeah. He's
helping us out here.
Look at AA-22, which
just
is an automatic
basic
shotgun.
Iron sight.
Yeah.
See?
Yeah, they're basic. So, I have seen a lot of the pictures. So, I'm wondering about the chat room's opinion about this stuff.
Yeah.
I don't have an opinion.
I generally when the big guy picks
well,
on
you
the
can
little
see
guy.
You can see some but you can see like you see
yeah,
this
that's
like
true.
The
that's,
that's
true.
Like the four dots, you know. But you know, I could totally imagine a gajillion scenarios like, "Oh, damn it, I have to make a gun for this game. I'll just like look at the gun in this
yeah.
other game, you know,
yeah,
as
yeah,
reference
yeah.
or something like that." And, you know,
I mean, that can be dangerous, but yeah.
if it's different enough, well, maybe they assumed it was a real gun in the game.
Absolutely.
Then,
I have
know.
No idea. It'll
I
be
have
interesting
no
have
idea.
They spoken out and given their side of the story yet.
Well, they're saying it's not true.
Okay.
It's not
they're
true. It's
like,
not true. It's not true. And Activision is, it's true. It's true. It's true. And now the game's off Steam and you can't shoot dinosaurs. I guess you win.
Yay, dinosaurs!
I guess the dinosaurs win.
the,
I guess
dinosaurs,
the dinosaurs win.
The dinosaurs live
yeah.
on.
And then
now
some,
you can just run
yeah.
around with so the dinosaurs.
So McCabe says they stole multiple guns, ran right down to the markings. Yeah,
okay.
so there are some parts here that look kind
so,
of...
So McCabe clearly thinks this is
yeah.
legit.
Yeah, so, I mean, if Activision won, that's
well,
kind of an indicator,
go and get
right?
other guns, plug them into your game, and move on.
Yeah,
really,
yeah.
Really.
That's true.
I'm sure there are other 3D rendered guns that are just out there.
Yeah. Actually, you can buy them on the asset store.
There you go.
Some people are saying it was a pretty bad game, that you should come to ARK, shoot dinos, and not worry about stolen game assets.
So ARK, you have... I don't know anything about ARK, but it's always like at the top of the page for me on Steam of like games you should buy, so I'm... very tempted.
Well, it's like the next game Zach and I are gonna play together on stream someday.
Okay.
So you should come in and
yeah.
join us.
Yeah,
it'll
yeah.
It'll be fun. So you have some awesome awards though at Origins.
Oh yeah, yeah. So
tell me about these.
Origins was a big convention that was also going on
mm-hmm.
while E3 was going on.
Yeah.
So it's one of the big board
it's
game
in
conventions.
France?
No.
No. Where?
No, you're thinking.
No, I'm thinking of something else.
It's in.
In another
Ohio.
State. Yeah.
So
round on both ends, high in the middle.
Anyways, so Origins was going on, and they had their big awards
mm-hmm.
winners, the big ceremony, which is a really cool thing because it's a whereas a lot of the other awards are picked by experts and stuff, Origins Award winners. You basically have fans, there's a vote, there's a bunch of other things. So we're going to look at that, and I just want to talk about some of these games. So.
Oh, and just in case you're just hopping in right now, you're watching Hyper RPG, yes. Awesome, out of this world, independent live streaming studio featuring all sorts of gaming stuff, digital, analog, yes. Interviews with developers, all sorts of things. And we really appreciate you following, subscribing, and just say hi in the chat room. It really helps us because we're just like an indie production.
We're basically the talk show where you get to talk to us.
Yeah. Well, I want to talk to you guys.
Yeah, like we get to talk about what you want to talk about. Because sometimes you turn on a talk show and you're like, eh.
We have a subscriber ARC server. Check out the Discord for details.
All right, I will. Absolutely.
That's good to know.
Except I have to buy it first. But it is on sale. Steam sale is the worst thing ever. Just
I know.
Take my money. Just take my wallet. There you go. Here, Steam. You can have it. There you go. All right. So Origins Awards. So first of all, we got to talk about Star Wars at the Origins Awards. It is ridiculous. Three of the winners were Star Wars games. Three of the winners. Yeah. Thanks. Best board game, Imperial Assault, which is this really sweet like game with little miniature stormtroopers and Jedi, and you're moving around on a board. Think of like
people from the movie?
Yeah. Okay. People from the movies. So think of like a dungeon crawl, awesome. But with Star Wars, right? So you're like fighting your way through stormtroopers.
Nice. And you can play cooperatively. Like lightsabers and...
So like me and Malika can play on a team where Zach is controlling the bad guys.
You're evil.
Oh yeah. I want to control the bad guys. So or Malika and Zach and Joe can play on a team versus me as the Imperials gunning you down because you are rebel scum.
Well, no. I'm a Jedi in training. We'll get there.
Rebel scum. So, yeah. So that one for best board game, which is a really big deal. I mean, think about all the board games that came out in the last year. And Imperial Assault wins. Best RPG is Force and Destiny. Best role-playing game of the year, which is a role-playing game all about Star Wars and specifically about being Jedi. So the thing that everybody wants to, and people have even combined some of these games where you can actually like play Force and Destiny and you get into a battle and you break out Imperial Assault to like run the battle. And then the third game, best miniatures game, is Star Wars Armada, which is a game with all the really big epic ships like Star Destroyers and
that kind of stuff. Winner of the Origins Fan Favorite Award.
And it also won the Fan Favorite Award because Armada is really good. So X-Wing is all about the little ships that are zipping around. Mm-hmm. Armada is about the huge lumbering ships that are blowing things up. And recently announced, we got to see, so I'm a big Star Wars fan and I've been reading a lot of the books of the new fandom, of the new canon, rather. And recently announced Sienna Ray, who's from Lost Stars, which if you have not read Lost Stars, you must read that book. It is like the best Star Wars book.
Lost Stars. So for everybody like myself and in the chat room, like I've never read a Star Wars book before.
I haven't read.
Can I just pick this one up?
Yes, you can just pick this one up.
Okay. That's good to know.
That is what is awesome about. So I don't know if you know, but they reset the canon. So like all the old books don't matter. Mm-hmm. And so it's a great time to start reading Star Wars books.
Yeah.
That's what I did. I never really read the old ones. But Sienna Ray
is like a lot to like.
There is. It is. Yeah. It's a lot to keep up with. So Sienna Ray is this amazing Imperial pilot.
Is that why you're going over the dark side?
She
got better pilots, eh?
And I don't want to give away spoilers, but her story arc in Lost Stars is amazing because it follows her all the way from growing up on this backwater planet to going to the Imperial Academy to basically watching all of her friends killed when the Death Star is destroyed.
Yeah.
To then being very angry about all of her friends being killed.
What does Yoda say? Yeah. Like, anger, fear leads to anger, anger leads to... Yeah.
So it follows her all the way through to actually the end scene to the book is that Star Destroyer that you see that Rey is pilfering through.
Oh, it's all connected.
She's on that Star Destroyer at the end of the book. And I don't want to give away spoilers, but it covers all of that time.
All right.
So good. So, anyways, the first artwork has been released of her.
Yeah, and she looks badass.
I know. I'm so excited about how...
Come to the light side, please.
We're getting a lot more diversity in the Star Wars
absolutely.
Universe.
Yeah. And I like seeing that not only in the films, but also in the games now.
Yeah, absolutely. And so, yeah, the books reflect the games, the, games reflect the comics,
awesome.
Everything
All right, goodbye, Kato-kun in the chat room.
Bye.
Somebody was asking, when are we doing the Cheap Ass Games interview? Those interviews usually happen at 2:15.
2:15, okay.
Very specifically.
Yes.
All right. Yeah, she Megalo Blazemon says she looks cool. She totally looks cool.
She is badass.
Right?
She's badass.
Badass.
You if you read the book, you're like, okay.
Badass.
She's badass.
Badass.
So read that book for sure.
And oh, it seems like Codenames was also the big favorite.
Oh yeah, so other Origins award winners.
Yeah.
Best party. Game, I think. Is that what it won?
Game of the Year.
Game of the Year. Sorry. Yeah. Game
of
the
Year
was Codenames.
Codenames.
Which is just, we have talked about it a lot.
Yeah,
an amazing
absolutely.
Game, but amazing
awesome.
Because anybody who plays that game falls in love with that
game.
Yeah,
it's a lot of fun. It's because it's so simple, and yet, like, it really racks your brain because you're like, ah, I can't say that. I want that extra card.
It'll be really fun to do a designer profile of Vlada Shvatil, who did Codenames,
be
because
awesome.
All of his other games are really complex.
Yeah.
And then he
but
comes
this
out with
this clean,
Codenames.
Minimalist.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So it just shows his breadth of ability. Yeah. And then the best card game is Seven Wonders Duel. And I think, is it last week or a few weeks ago, you guys were asking me about the best two-player games? Like games for you and
right,
Zach to play?
Right. Or like, I don't need a gajillion people to play these tabletop games.
Exactly. So Codenames Duel is, Seven Wonders Duel is specifically a two-player game.
Awesome.
And it may be one of the best two-player games ever made. Like, it's really, really good.
Seven Wonders Duel. I'm going to look this up.
Yeah, so in Seven Wonders Duel, basically you are drafting cards, but they're laid out in a fashion so that if I pick up this card, it unlocks other cards for you.
Oh, yeah, I've seen this one. Yeah.
So definitely check that game out. And if you love Seven Wonders, but you're like, I want to play it with like five people, you know, Seven Wonders isn't very good at three player
sure.
or two player for sure. This is the game.
Awesome.
So 8.2 Board Game Geek rating, by the way. I don't know how much you know this, but Board Game Geek people.
Yeah, it's like Rotten Tomatoes. It's really tough.
Yeah, it's really tough. So an 8.2 is a really high score.
Exactly. So I just wanted to mention this because some of you guys have supported me at home. I used to stream fitness games from Zach's old apartment. Yeah. So look at this, guys. Microsoft is shutting down Xbox Fitness.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Now you'll have to stream.
Like, was I the only one playing games on Xbox Fitness, guys? It's still available for a year. And
chat?
I'm like, oh, my gosh.
Was she the only person?
Is this, like, my chance? If I can get all the internet to play Xbox Fitness, it won't go away.
Yeah, good luck with that.
And, like, so one of the things that I loved, besides, like, Jillian Michaels, you can work out with her.
Okay.
You see this? So this is, like, a silhouette of you, like, doing the exercise.
Oh, because it uses the Kinect, right?
Right, it uses the Kinect, and it shows. You see how, like, this part is, like, hotter than this part?
Yeah.
So that means, like, you're really working out that muscle right then and there.
Yeah,
and it was
really smart.
Super rewarding to be doing squats and exercises.
And be like, this is where I'm getting stronger.
Right. And it would even say, like, you know, it'll say, like, dig deeper, nice high. Kicks, a nice low squat, so it rewards
you.
I'm
surprised
really
it's
pushing yourself.
Do they have any other exercise software on the?
So
Xbox?
They have like a. There's a lot of exercise games and programs on Xbox Fitness, but it's also kind of a living service, and they're like, yeah, we don't want to maintain it. And I'm like, what? Because so every time you finish a workout, you collect these fit points, and then you go on a leaderboard, so then you'll. Super motivated to be like,
because you want
to
be the best,
one of the top, like,
absolutely
all on Xbox.
I am the most fit,
exactly. Or you just did a lot of squats, dude. Right? And then, like, if you squat deeper, you get more points.
What? Oh, because Kinect can figure that out,
exactly. And like, for people who are like self conscious, don't have time to go to the gym, you know, I lived in Los Angeles, money, and like driving across town took like 45
traffic
minutes.
Traffic is the worst,
yes, exactly. So I could just do this at home. And one of the greatest things was when I was streaming it, people were writing me and tweeting me these amazing things. Like, I had extra food, but I put it aside because I saw how hard you were working and inspired me. So
it's just because it's a living thing that they just don't want to support it. I'm surprised.
I think
like,
they just, yeah,
it feels like it hits a really, because it feels like the whole idea of Xbox One is we're more than a gaming machine. Right.
It's like an everything machine.
It's an everything machine.
It's a workout machine.
Yeah. So it surprises me that they would kill something like this. Well,
anyway.
Microsoft's right up the street. We can.
All right. Everybody in the chat room, there's been a lot of chatter, but just be nice. Everybody, be nice. Be classy.
I agree, Zanzibar. What's interesting is a lot of game designers, I remember when Kinect first came out, a lot of game designers were coming in telling me these ideas they had of how to use it, and I never saw those come to fruition.
So one of my friends did an awesome game. I'm going to pull it up real quick. It's called Perfect Woman. I have to do this quick because we're running out of time. But it's awesome.
We like to talk too much.
It's definitely a feminist game. Hold on.
Okay.
And it's an Xbox Kinect game.
Okay.
And basically, you are trying to be the perfect woman.
Whoa.
And you are trying to fit in the silhouette of this perfect woman.
Man.
And it's like the perfect game mechanic.
Gotcha.
Be as perfect as possible, and it was made at the UCLA.
They're missing eyes.
Lab.
This is Mary. Mary has it all. She's pretty.
Thanks for resubscribing,
Spider-MX. Thank you.
Yeah.
Spider-MX. You're the best.
So,
Mary has an ambitious career.
I don't know
also
if.
Found her inner peace. She's cultural, and she has really.
I don't know.
Oh,
here we go.
Woman.
So you like have to fit the silhouette.
Position yourself in front of the Kinect so it can track and analyze.
And as the character grows up, it's harder to match the poses.
No.
Yeah. So I think there are actually really awesome Xbox.
You know what? I love co-hosting with you, Malika, because these are the kinds of games I would never know about. And you tell me about them.
Well, thank you. You just gotta hang around more weirdos. More weirdos than me.
I've been trying. I keep my weirdo quota up.
So I think there is one story I really, really wanted to talk about. And the mods, I had no idea this was going on. And the mods brought it up with me. So I'm just gonna.
All right, let's
see. So bullying is an epidemic. You might have heard of Jennifer Helper, and she left BioWare a while back because of death threats to not only herself but her family and her kids.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Just like really, really messed up. So she talked about some of this stuff.
Am I allowed to like publicly be opposed to Gamergate on here?
Sure.
Oh good, because
yeah,
I'm very
totally.
Opposed.
Totally. Well,
this has actually taken Gamergate hate before.
Really?
Yeah.
I have even like a board game
store. One of our stores, our store in Tacoma, got a lot of hate for being like too open to anybody being able to be there to play games and stuff like that. So we got like a whole Reddit thread that was pretty gross.
That's so really weird.
Super opposed. Sorry.
I participated in a discussion. Anyways, I agree like there should be ethics in journalism regardless.
Right.
And I'm sure you have thoughts about that because didn't you study journalism?
I did.
Absolutely.
So that's
not the problem.
No, not at all.
It's like trying to kill people.
That is not what.
That's the problem.
Yeah. we could move that line even further back.
Sure.
Like threatening
ethics in journalism
people.
Important. Threatening people is illegal. You know. I think she had an interesting perspective on the whole issue. So she spoke on it at the Games for Change Festival, and I don't know if you've heard about Games for Change.
No.
Oh, dude, this is like totally your festival, dude.
Okay.
So it's digital and analog, and it's a festival that highlights what people call serious games.
Yes.
So games for education, for healthcare, for for mental stuff, for social justice.
Where's the festival at?
It's in another state that I've never been to. Either,
okay,
but
all right.
I've been meaning to go there. It's in the United States.
Yeah. All right.
And she spoke about bullying because right now she works at an awesome company. They're called Cognito, and they use virtual humans to drive behavior change. So this is really cool. This is the Cognito, and these are like the virtual humans. And so BioWare and Dragon Age, a lot of those games, they do conversation by conversation trees, right?
Yeah.
So it's like the writer writes this option or this option,
right,
depending on how how you respond. But what's interesting about some of the research they're doing at Cognito is they're actively listening and looking for behavior cues to make the reply. So it's a little smarter than just branching trees. And what was really interesting is, so they did a few studies and they took some at-risk teens, and 71% of the students in this group actually asked other students if you need help. Like, they were encouraged to reach out because they were using this Cognito.
That's amazing.
Yeah, isn't that incredible?
That's really amazing.
So, but what was
I want to hear about her talk. I'm excited to.
Right. So she was, she said a lot of stuff, and this is what I got from it was, that there is a male power fantasy. See, Helper said it started, all right, let me just scroll right up here so I don't misquote her. So a lot of big commercial games are selling stories about a male power fantasy, she said in her talk on Friday. In a lot of these stories, the hero tends to be ruthless. Dragon Age wanted to try something different about a character with a family, a home, to protect citizenship. The whole team wrote a very independent-minded characters, which sounds really fascinating, you know, and I don't think it is necessarily unempowering. Like, you can still go and have, you know, adventures, right?
Right, absolutely.
And so as the team continued to explore these ideas in deeper and different ways, Hepler said it started to fly in the face of the power fantasy that developers, including herself, had been training gamers to expect.
Gotcha.
A lot of hardcore gamers lost their collective minds about it. They spewed a ton of vitriol, most of that aimed at me. It was really horrific. But I'm not the first person to be targeted like this. No. Bullying is an epidemic. So it's interesting that she took responsibility for it as well, that we, you know, create. I don't think we, as game developers, I mean, I can only speak for myself, but I don't set out to create a power fantasy.
No.
But in the nature of creating something interactive, something that changes around you while you, provide input into that system. Like, all games are just, they're simply about system and putting in input. And one of the design mantras.
Well, all games by nature are fantasy. It's the power part that can become the issue. Right?
Well, what I was going to say is one of the design mantras that I actually follow is minimum input, maximum output. That's why a game feels fun.
Gotcha.
Right?
Yep.
But unfortunately, that can perpetuate a power fantasy. That's that's what how I interpret it.
Yeah.
I know this is like a hot subject for you guys. I would love to hear your opinions.
It can just be hard to.
Yeah.
Even people who mean well, they're kind of in this culture.
Right. Right.
The culture affects
you. Right. Right.
Even subconsciously.
And then also just bullying is a problem. And I like that line that she said up here.
Especially in this digital world, like.
Yeah. Unfortunately. Especially
that is why our fans are the best.
Yes, but also happiness, kindness, love, and all the shipping.
Yeah,
can be
I know.
By
I
awesome
jump
guys.
On Discord and everybody is just talking good stuff.
Yeah, they're like good people. I know.
Yeah,
they're
love it.
They're wonderful. So, and then it says the hero tends to be ruthless. Yeah, male or female. You are a hero because you are ruthless. You know?
Right.
And
right.
You know, we don't create these games that reward love or listening to each other or those kinds of things.
Yes.
That's why
I agree strongly.
Some of the themes of Grab Bag today are hugs and fist bumps. See, I have a method to my madness. All right.
Well, I feel like in a lot of media too, we've started to move towards this idea where the egotistical character is often the protagonist, and that's always bothered me.
Well, you're a writer, so tell me about some of your thoughts.
Well, just that. Like, just the idea that there's been a trend, I feel like, in television.
Yeah.
Shows like House is an example, maybe, of, like, where there's
but
this
I
character.
But I love House so much.
Everybody loves House,
She's
right?
Brilliant.
But at the same time, it...
He is ruthless. You have a good point.
Yeah, it kind of glorifies ego,
right?
So, as a writer, sometimes...
I think it glorifies confidence.
Yes.
I think it glorifies confidence for sure. And I think it's definitely a part of our culture.
And part of House is that he grows through that, right?
Right.
But still, especially early on and other shows like that, I've seen a lot of this where characters are often rewarded for ignoring the other.
Right.
And so that it can be a real problem. And I think culturally, we have to be careful That one of the reasons, I mean, one of the big reasons I moved and lived in Africa for a while was to get my brain outside of my own culture for a little while.
Yeah, that's really interesting.
Yeah.
Ruthless as in a roamer, no home, no family, Han Solo. No, I think even, I'm trying to like unpack why for
myself. It's a hard thing to unpack.
Yeah, like why would I kind of idolize somebody who is ruthless, right?
Because right.
I feel that inside myself where I'm like, oh, this person put aside their feelings, you know, to just kind of get the job done, right?
You know what's interesting though is, at least for me personally, I've gone through a personal journey with that because living in Baltimore, people are just much more ruthless. It's a cultural, sure, but it's a very cultural, like, you have to show strength.
Oh, it says, Malika, I think you're misreading rootless as ruthless. Uh-huh. I think, you know what? I think you're right, but I think there's some overlap.
I think there is overlap.
Yeah.
But regardless, in moving to the West Coast and living in the West Coast for over a decade now, I've come to understand that isn't necessarily always a positive thing to always be showing this sense of power.
Right.
So, yeah.
I mean, it's also a defense mechanism and stuff, right?
Absolutely. It definitely is.
Yeah. Harry Dresden is ruthless but kind. That's an interesting point. Those are really popular books, too.
They are. It'd be interesting to look at that across genres, across characters.
Sure.
Like, what's the correct balance?
Correct balance. I think there is no correct balance.
Sure. Well, that's part of being a writer is you are exploring that, right? So.
Unfortunately, sad situation. But I think her work now at Cognito and the stuff that they're doing is really making an impact in the world, and it's looking promising. So any quick announcements? Because our interview is coming up in just a minute.
Cassidy would have been a good person to bring in on that conversation.
Well, we can always bring that conversation right back up. There's a lot of cool stuff going on. Just real quick here. Did you know Simplicity now puts out a licensed cosplay? Look at that.
Whoa.
Look at that. Wow. So you can, I'm just waiting.
Licensed cosplay.
Oh my god, that's like old school Joker.
Yeah.
Wonder Woman. Like old school Wonder Woman.
So on one hand, it's cool because you can just.
Yeah.
PayPal your way to cosplay.
Well,
but also cosplay.
Just the pattern.
Oh, it's just the pattern.
You have to still show it.
That. Yeah. Got it.
But
because I know a lot of the love for cosplay is in the creation, right?
And but sometimes it's really tough. Like, I don't know. I've never. Is that like silkscreened on, or do you sew that star on? You know.
Right.
So the pattern might teach you some of those.
Now, how much is this? Do you think has been created with the intention of cosplay, and how much of it is kind of Halloween stuff that they've rebranded?
I think they're like, we don't care. Comic books are taking off right
Exactly. Cosplay is a thing.
Let's make money.
Exactly.
Right?
It's super cool.
No, it's definitely really cool. And then also, I forgot her name. I can see her face. She is a very famous cosplayer, and now she has a line of cosplay fabrics at Joann's.
Oh, wow. Like cosplay fabrics?
Yeah, cosplay fabrics.
Wow. That's really cool.
Somebody in the chat room, I know you know what I'm talking about.
I'm not really into cosplay, and yet I am surrounded by friends who are like really into that community.
Because it's so much fun to be your favorite hero.
I know, and it's just so creative.
Just
I love
like
watching their process
be...
of like building stuff. And one of my friends was just, actually one of my old employees, she made a Sword of Fire and Ice from Magic the Gathering, which is a famous Magic card. And it was like featured on Wizards of the Coast, on Magic.
That's awesome, yeah. And I know that like Marvel had like a cover for one of their books that was a cosplayer.
Yeah.
Yaya Han. So Yaya Han, who's a really, really, really famous, like on Sci-Fi Network type cosplayer, she did her own line of cosplay fabrics at Joann's and patterns.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's really
that's
cool.
That's awesome.
Because Joann's is a huge store, but a lot of the fabric is targeted towards crafting rather than like clothing.
Right.
you know, or like home fabrics.
Have you been over to Crossroads where we have Joanne's and
Michael's? Yeah, and Michael's, yeah.
Like next to that.
I was there yesterday.
That's pretty amazing.
I was there yesterday. Yeah, I met her. Yeah, it was really nice. No, she's a really, really incredible awesome. Cosplayer, and her work is extremely detailed. So I think we got to switch on over. It's time for our interview with Cheap Ass Games. Joe, do you want to cue up our
Cassidy
trailer?
It's time to play TAC. I'm James Ernest. I'm a game designer, and I've been working for about a year now with my friend Patrick Rothfuss on a game called TAC. TAC is described in Patrick's book, The Wise Man's Fear, and when he wrote the book, he talked about how amazing the game was, but there actually wasn't a game. And now we've had a chance to get together and write a real game to go in that spot.
And honestly, I didn't want to. I like so didn't want to. And I said something along the lines of, you can't make it, nobody can make it, and if you made it, you wouldn't be able to make it right, and if you did make it right, nobody would want to play it. So I was like a real cheerleader.
So you got that to look forward to.
Yeah. And he goes, just let me, and eventually he warned me, he says, let me do it, I'll just show it to you, and if you don't like it, it's fine. So almost exactly a year ago, he shows up with this thing, and it was so good. It was just so beautiful, and it was elegant, and it was easy to learn, and it was simple, and it was really irritating because I hate being wrong.
I'm best known as a humor game designer, but I am also pretty good at abstract strategy games. In fact, I've even won some awards with them.
You can put a piece on an empty space, or you can move a piece that's already on the board. Either a piece or a stack of pieces. And they go, what are the winning conditions? I'm like, you're trying to make a road from either this side to this side or this side to this side. And I'm like, so let's go. And at first you're like, And then you can see it happens in every game. Once the pieces start stacking up, it suddenly like becomes logarithmically more complex in its permutations, but not in the play.
The rules for TAC are already free online. You can download them from cheapass.com. And we're also going to post a how to play video as a part of this campaign. We are bringing TAC to Kickstarter because honestly, we have no idea how many we should print. It's a brand new kind of game for us, and we just can't even guess how big the demand is going to be.
So what happened was about a year ago, James came to me and said, Pat, you know that you write books, but what I've really always admired about you is your ability to design games. And I'd like you to teach me everything that you know about designing games. I can't even pretend.
That was when I told Pat everything I knew about writing books.
TAC is just super good. I can't wait to play it with you. So thanks for watching the video. Learn all about it down below, and thanks for playing.
Welcome back, everybody. We have Cassidy from Cheap Ass Games. The Sweetie Pie is in the house. Sorry, I told everybody you're really awesome.
Are we allowed to swear on the show?
Yes.
Fuckity fuck fuck.
Oh, wow. Cassidy is in the house. She is in the house.
It's Joe.
Hey, Joe.
Hi, Joe. So
Joe's making sure that you can see this beautiful game, TAC.
Yay.
Yes. It is a beautiful game.
It's even called TAC.
A beautiful game. So, can you tell me about this beautiful game in front of us?
Yes, I can. So, are you familiar with Patrick Rothfuss? Pretend you are if you're not.
I am.
He is an author.
Yeah.
But for the people
the
in the chat
has already been talking
not
a lot.
Heard about.
Yes.
So, Patrick Rothfuss is a very famous author. He wrote The Kingkiller Chronicle. And in the second book, Wise Man's Fear, he talks about TAC being a beautiful game. And luckily for us, he did not describe the rules. He tried designing it himself, and I think I think I'm using his word, so this isn't mean.
Oh, thanks for resubscribing!
Woo! Yay! Thank you for resub. That is 20 months. Thank you very much. Oh, and we had a 1 month. That's 21 months.
Yes. Kaiju for the win.
21 Yay! Months of subscribing.
Somebody likes my dog.
Woo! Sorry. That happens.
That's awesome.
Here. You'll get used to it.
Well, she was at the charity stream.
Yeah, the charity stream was way more chaotic than anything we
do.
Yeah,
none of you had sleep, and none of you could talk, and there was dancing.
And also, we were trolling goobers with moist.
We're trying to help kids.
Moist goobers.
Oh, you remember that.
Dude, we started that.
Yeah,
It's Joe.
Sorry,
Joe.
Microphone.
Hi, Joe.
Cassidy, by the way, is soft-spoken.
I'm sorry.
I'll
speak louder.
No, it's fine.
I'll speak louder.
You have just a soft-spoken demeanor.
Yell at me in caps, and then I'll speak louder. But Pat tried designing tack on his own, and it went terribly.
Yeah.
I think I'm using his words there.
Bloody Heart 120, thanks for following. You are awesome. Welcome aboard the Yojimbo.
So do you remember kind of what was mentioned in the book at all? Like what...
So the main character, Kavoth, plays games with Brayden, and they describe it as a beautiful game. He doesn't really go into a lot of detail.
Really?
Yeah.
He doesn't talk. I thought there was a little bit of detail.
Ars Prothetica, thanks for following.
Yay, thanks for following.
For the Yojimbo. Woo! Woo!
Hey, see, chat saying hi, Cassidy. Ah. Everybody greet Cassidy. She's the best.
She's the
you
bestest.
Would love her.
I love her.
So he doesn't really go into details, and then James essentially bugged the snot out of him for a year until he let him try it.
I believe that.
Awesome.
Yeah. I believe that.
Yep. So now here it is.
Here it is.
Yeah, and congratulations on the successful Kickstarter.
Thank you.
It like surpassed the goal by a gajillion times.
Yeah, roughly that. I think
what was the total dollar?
$1.35 million.
Yeah.
$1.35 million.
What was the original goal? It was like 50,000 or something.
The original goal wasn't the real goal, but it was 50,000.
Sure.
That's like the least amount we would have done it for.
Right.
Yeah.
Awesome. And I saw, so you guys, can you tell me about this Wormwood who does the beautiful...
Yeah, Wormwood is, they make really pretty game components out of ethically sourced, made in USA wood.
Oh, awesome.
Oh, cool.
So they're doing a board based off a character in the book named Debbie, who is my favorite.
Okay.
Debbie is a moneylender.
Yeah.
And I don't want to give spoilers to anyone who hasn't read the book.
Yeah.
But
thanks a lot, Cassidy.
I'm sorry. Ruined everything. But both money and blood are very relevant to her character. So they have the pieces and shapes of the money from the book, and they also have bloodwood accents.
Oh,
and
my goodness.
It's going to be super pretty.
That is gorgeous. Yeah, so they're like, where are they? I couldn't find that out.
Somewhere in the middle.
In the
of the country. I don't know exactly where.
That sounds
they do
amazing.
Amazing, beautiful things. Yeah, and it's really cool that you guys are collaborating. And
yeah, they reached out to us, and I was like,
Wormwood?
Okay.
Oh, cool. Do we have to?
Cool.
That's amazing.
Yeah, Wormwood, exactly. W-Y-M.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Yeah, W-Y. There
Cassie,
we go.
Why don't you introduce yourself and kind of how did you get started into the game industry?
Oh, I quit my corporate job to take an unpaid internship at Paizo 4 years ago. Just kind of flipped the table
on
my job. Yeah. Felt really
Paizo.
Good. We do.
Yeah,
I love Paizo.
Cool.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
This is the new show launch. It's about to launch, right?
I think they are doing a trial tonight.
Tonight
at 6. Yeah.
Awesome.
There's a new show.
There's a new Paizo show.
A new Paizo show.
But they're not like really doing it. I think they're like setting it up in the background. I'm not quite sure.
Okay.
That's awesome.
Sorry, go on.
No, it was good. And from Paizo, I jumped to Calliope, and Calliope is a great company, very family friendly, but I am not. And neither is Cheapass. So.
Note opening.
So now I'm there, and basically my job is to tweet and give stuff away.
Yes.
Awesome.
That's awesome. What a great job. And
so,
you're good at it.
Some people were asking again, what book are we talking about that Tack came from?
A Wise Man's Fear from the King Killer Chronicle.
Yes.
Yeah. And
So Cassidy, one of the things I love about you is you are constantly talking about how much you love working in the industry.
Mm-hmm.
But why? I don't think
why?
I've ever heard the like.
Because we have the best job ever. We make games. If we screw up, it's fine. No one dies. And we get to make really cool products. And
if we fail, nobody dies. That's that's a good bare minimum.
So it's like we never really have a bad day because even if stuff is going wrong, I mean, we're just having fun in the end.
Well,
and it's
nice.
It brings people together.
Sometimes people act like they're going to die.
That is true.
I heard you had a fun experience.
A wise man fear, right?
A wise man's fear.
A wise man's fear.
Yes.
He might be afraid of a spear, but it's not a spear. There we go.
A wise man's fear. What kind of, like, can you tell me about Cheap Ass Games? Like, how many people are there working?
There are three of us.
There's three of you.
Three of us.
People.
And then how long have y'all been together?
Are you Southern now? All of a sudden?
I've always
been.
Take note,
people from video game industry, by the way, like, a small video game publisher is what? How many people, you would say?
I don't know, man. Like, so HBS is about 50, and I consider that
50,
a small
right?
company. Yeah.
And Cheap Ass Games, I wouldn't even consider necessarily a small board game publisher.
Micro publisher.
Yeah, they're right. And you are three people. That's the difference in industries
wow.
right there. Yeah.
That's what? Incredible.
Yeah. James' office is in his basement. He never leaves. just there.
So do you go
working.
To his basement?
Every once in a while.
That sounds creepy. it's like,
especially
oh, I gotta talk to my boss, and it's like, he's in his basement. Is your boss Batman? You're like,
maybe like an angrier Batman.
Yeah,
yeah.
If
Batman's
Simon
already
Powell
pretty angry.
Was a Batman, like.
does he flip tables kind of angry?
I don't think I've ever seen him flip a table,
sure.
but he does have a workshop.
It's more like
now,
he projects
so.
Mentally. A table flip.
He'll flip a table with his words.
Yes.
Oh man.
Yeah.
He's pretty good.
But he's actually a really nice boss.
Yeah.
He is.
So.
He's fantastic.
Yeah. He's just angry in his cape.
He's just. We were talking about this earlier. He's very sure.
Okay.
He's very sure of himself.
That's good.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
But that's what enables
important.
Good game design, right?
Exactly.
Like you're like, okay, I know what I want to do. If you go and watch the episode of Grab Bag that he was on, you can kind of see that actually.
Okay.
So, yeah.
So, can you explain how this goes?
Yeah.
How does TAC play?
So in
TAC, how do we play TAC?
You are trying to make a road from one side of the board to the other.
How do I crush Malika
at TAC? Or that side.
All right.
So you can't go diagonal. So this would not be a win condition.
Because it's diagonal.
Right. But this would.
Yes.
You can turn.
Okay.
On your turn, you can place a stone in a empty space, always in an empty space. You can place a flat stone to help build your road, or you can place a wall to block your opponent. This does not count
That's
as part
correct.
Of your road.
Oh.
You also have one power piece called a capstone that can crush walls.
Oh, okay.
You can also make stacks, so steal some of your pieces over here. So all of these would be individual moves. Whoever's on top of the stack controls it. You can move stacks, so this would be one turn. You have to leave at least one, but if more if you want, in every space. And you can't turn corners with stacks.
Right.
And that is essentially the game.
Yeah, it's really simple.
So one thing is, with this power piece, if I wanted to take down a wall, do I have to kind of travel to that?
Yes, yes. Once you place it on the board. It's there.
Oh, okay. And do you have to start from
You can start from
side?
Any edge.
From any edge.
From any
from,
edge.
From
Sorry.
Any
it's your job to
No, it's okay.
This okay. Game. I really like this game.
Yeah, so your road can start on any of the edges. So if you want to do a play game, and I'll
okay.
tell you what you're doing wrong,
sure.
it'll be a learning game, you each place one of your opponent's pieces
Wait, what,
to start.
What if we play in like a 3x3?
You can do that.
So let's
okay.
ignore the outside
right.
and start here.
So
and
we have...
Will, we might actually...
Okay.
So
yeah.
she's placed there, so I could also...
You might actually beat me, is that what you're saying?
No, I'm just, you know...
This guy's
this
on the
game,
dark side,
this
look.
I know. Imperial...
So in a 3x3, I'm going to take away your capstones.
Okay.
And we also have way too many pieces.
No capstones?
No capstones right, in a 3x3.
Right, go ahead. All I have to do... Yep, that's all you would have to do, except... Boom! In your face!
I feel like she's a little bit angry. It's like compressed angry, so I don't know if I would say that if I were you.
Malika?
Yeah.
She might be, but I'm bad at reading people.
See that carefully neutral face?
Oh, see? All right.
People
so,
tell me I'm hard to read. I don't believe that, but.
I can go like this.
Yeah.
Yes, you can.
You can be a jerk that way. Do it.
You could also. Could you go like diagonally and then connect it, or do you have to always kind of?
You can place a piece anywhere you want on the board.
Oh, okay.
You
so I could put one here.
Yep. Absolutely.
Okay. But do I want to?
Yes, that is really how you play.
Okay.
Someone is asking in the chat room. You can find the rules on cheapass.com for free.
Oh, yeah, cool. One of the really cool things that James did is he kind of crowdsourced the rules, right?
Yeah, he always puts up a, well, almost always puts up a demo online, and then we accept feedback from the internet as a whole, which I feel like is the harshest kind of feedback you can ask for. From the internet as a whole?
That's, yeah, it can be difficult. Except for our community is
Yeah, your community is full of hugs and bunnies, and it's fair. Awesome.
Seriously, you guys are amazing.
Yeah.
But I think it's really cool that he allowed people to input and play test and,
yeah.
You know, because a lot of people, they wouldn't do that. And just the idea that it has, like, this game has already been heavily play tested,
mm-hmm.
which I think gets it to the level of a chess awesome. Caliber
Yeah.
Right?
Oh no, I lost. Right?
I can't place on top of her, right?
Yeah.
I can?
You cannot.
Yeah, I didn't think I could.
Okay.
So you have not lost yet.
Okay. Wait, how come you could place on top of this but not that?
I have to move like this to do that.
Oh. Okay. So did I win now?
Yes.
Oh yeah, you did. Oh. Dang on it. I was because there was a 3x3, I was just looking for straight across like tic-tac-toe.
Yeah, it has some kind of a little bit of tic-tac-toe, but better.
Yes.
Well, when you get to a bigger board, it's not tic-tac-toe, but
no, there's some stuff there.
Sure.
Do you have like a favorite play? Was there moments that you've ever seen that you're like, whoa, that was crazy?
I'll tell you my favorite play when she's done.
I just like making big towers and unstacking
big
them.
Yeah.
No.
We had something over, I was at Texacon over the weekend, and we made the biggest tower ever. It was like six.
Oh, wow.
It was giant. Six pieces, eight pieces. But I got
Thank
a picture
you,
with them.
Aw, there's a lot of people said that there's hugs for everybody.
Yay, hugs.
Yay.
As long as there's consent. That's a good point. Thanks.
Consent hugs.
Thanks.
Yeah.
I think one really cool thing about this game that I've noticed as I played it is you can almost bluff your way to a win.
Well, that's why I was, like, distracting your attention.
Huh? Well, yeah. Good job. So, but a lot of times I'll try and set it up so it looks like I'm trying to build this
sure.
road over here.
Just
but
like
I'm
chess.
Actually building a road
yeah.
over here.
Yeah, yeah. For sure.
I
yeah.
love it.
We got
so
to the
good.
Last day of the Kickstarter, and I was like, James, you and I have never actually played a game of tack. It was horrible. He destroyed me.
Yeah.
And I was like, I have all this complicated strategy over here, and he just built a straight line over one side of the board. And I was like, oh, the shame.
To bring the show back around, I would say if a son of Hermes from Mage was playing a board game, this would be the board game he would play.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
So does, who goes first? How is that determined?
Randomly, we recommend playing two games.
Heads or tails? Oh, that's like...
Use one of your shiny coins.
Damn it. Because, like, chess is white always goes first. And there's a whole strategy behind that.
You mean the opposite.
White always goes first in chess.
Guess I'm wrong. The board game is wrong.
White always goes first in chess. Oh,
Does
my
white
God.
Always go first in chess?
Chat room, back me up on this one. White always goes first in chess.
Black
All
goes
right.
first. See?
Okay, so now you start by placing one of your opponent's pieces. Yeah. Are you guys going to do a 5x5
yeah,
game now?
We can try
sure.
that.
Yeah,
all right.
So you get your capstones now.
Even faster than I expected on the 3x3. Wait. Oh, she put me in the middle. Okay.
Nice of her.
Gives me.
Yeah, maybe I'll get him to think too much about his strategy while I'm just, you know, building a line across the board.
It looks like you have some soft things you can just throw at his head
sure,
while
sure,
he's playing.
Sure.
It'd be good.
We have one of Paul Peterson's little table flips out there.
So.
Oh, okay. I love Paul. White
Malika is correct. I'm wrong. What?
Yeah, white is first on chess. It's
oh, and Go. Oh, because I've been playing a bunch of Go lately.
Is Go, the dark goes first?
Apparently. Well, yes, it
you?
Is. All right. I thought it was both the same for chess and Go, but I am wrong. I discovered Go about 3 months ago, and I've gotten a little bit addicted, but I can't even beat the like lowest level of AI.
Oh.
I'm really bad.
It's okay. You'll get it someday.
You
should teach your kid, and then maybe your kid
yeah,
will start
it's
beating
generational.
You, and then, yeah.
It was one of those games that, you know, as an owner of a board game store, I feel like I should know how to play, but I had just
yeah.
never gotten around to.
Go.
So.
Are you a chess player?
No, clearly, because, I mean, I used to be, but not really. But around one of our stores. Yeah, there's like national a huge champions and stuff hang out
is
there.
Is that the people that like hang out like by the giant chess set?
Yeah. So classroom? Actually, one of the world champions, like former, not world, national champions, mm-hmm. actually hangs out there and like gives lessons and stuff. And
what?
He's like from
what?
Nine
like he's
Brody,
like a he's like a grandmaster.
Yeah,
chess player.
Seriously.
Oh my gosh,
just chilling in the mall.
He's what? Amazing. Yeah, the chess players are really cool. There's also some Go players. What are you up to, Malika?
I don't know.
Apparently, James played many, many games of this at Origins with J.R. Honeycutt, who was a game designer at Artana.
Yeah,
that's a really
of
cool
course.
Podcast. But they've decided to name that the Earnest Cross, what you guys almost started out with right there.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
The Earnest Cross.
The Earnest Cross.
We got really quiet all of a sudden.
Super quiet.
Well, that's
we
the
are
thing
thinking.
About this game.
It's a thinking game.
Is that, yeah.
James and Pat were playing this on screen at Emerald City Comic Con, and Pat generously let James demonstrate a number of ways to win. That's how that went.
Oh, you can do that?
No, you can only drop.
Oh, is it only one?
You can't pick up. You can only drop as you go.
Oh, I can only drop as I go. Okay.
Yeah.
So where was I? There?
Yeah.
Yes? I can't
yeah.
remember. Stream.
No, wait. You went here, and then you
oh, okay.
Go right. So you can move over your black, or you can move your black and the white.
I can go like that, right?
You can do that, yeah.
Okay.
All right. All right. For some reason, I thought I could just keep going in a straight line, as long as it was a straight line.
I think that's how you win the game. Okay.
Nice. There you go. It's really cool working with Pat on the lore of this game.
Yeah.
He and James
so
are working
what
on
what is some of the lore that... Is there some lore that was developed while you were designing the game? Like, while the game was being made?
They're writing a companion book together, so I think I think James approached it from a purely game mechanic standpoint first.
Okay, yeah, of course.
And then once it got to the point where it was playable, Pat had input and kind of worked it around what he'd already discussed in the book.
Yeah.
And as part of the Kickstarter, we're doing a companion book with tack variations from around Pat's world.
Gotcha.
One of the really cool pieces of lore is that everyone who plays tack carries around their own special capstone. So these pieces here.
Oh, so this is
really
like
be anything.
Almost like a seal. So like a king would have like some
yeah.
really fancy one, and then us.
Someone else could have a pretty rock.
Yeah, a rock.
Yeah.
Huh.
I use my wedding ring a lot if I'm playing. It is fun.
Oh, interesting.
Small magnets underneath
each
square.
That way
they
interesting.
Only hold on the piece that's in the square. That's interesting, yeah.
Until you have the wrong magnet placed down and it shoots it across.
No!
That was suggested as part of the Kickstarter, like
it
tack in space.
It could have little like notches.
Yes, but then we get to the manufacturing sourcing that makes board game people want to cry.
Yeah. Often part of... So when you make a video game, you're just like, I have ideas. And then those ideas are just modeled. But when you make a board game, you're like, I have ideas. Oh, those ideas cost 3 times more than I wanted them to cost. It's tough.
Yeah, especially because we prefer to make our pieces in the U.S.
Yeah, that's
so
really cool. I didn't even
difficult.
Know that.
Do a lot of your... backers, are they in the United States or are they elsewhere?
They're all over the place. Yeah. I mean, the vast majority are from the U.S., but we have backers from Thailand and the U.K. and
cool.
Not excited about figuring out how to ship to the U.K. since they just voted to leave. It's exciting.
That's another story. But we have actually a lot of awesome fans from the U.K. in our chat room.
Oh,
really?
Yeah,
that's awesome.
And in Canada.
I agree, Gaia CA. I also love anything made of wood. It just feels good.
Feels
it's like
good.
Poker chips.
So
right?
You said you can move, right? But you can't just place. So I
yes,
can do that.
Correct.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can totally
okay.
do that.
I have a little sandwich there.
Yeah, don't do that.
Nom nom.
Yeah,
James made these in his basement as a wood workshop, which Carol is not happy about, and all my stock is covered in a fine layer of tack sawdust.
I want to not lose, but I also want
to
like
talk to chat.
Talk it's
to
very
the chat
hard
room.
To do both.
Canada hype, yeah. I bet I could make a metal travel version of this, but it wouldn't want to take away from the developers. Well, you know, I think you're totally fine to create it for yourself. I mean,
yeah, personal use is fine.
Yeah, so yeah. I think that you guys have even gotten on Twitter and stuff, a lot of people showing off their really cool.
Yeah, access, we love people making their own sets.
Yeah.
Yeah, once you. So trademark law is stupid, so you can't make sets to sell or distribute at this point.
Right. So don't do that. Don't be like, oh, I love this game. I'm going to make a bunch of them and sell them. But if you want to make your own custom
then
set.
By all means.
Even like the fact that everybody carries around their own capstone, that's really cool. So that means you could just make your own custom capstone.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, like engrave your initial.
Exactly. I think that'd be really cool.
That'd be cool. And then you'd have to create a light one and a dark one. Right?
Well, no, not if I always show up with, because don't people just carry around their own pieces? Is that how it works?
Well, what if you're both carrying a dark capstone?
Oh, that's true. I don't know. That's a good question.
It probably wouldn't look exactly the same, but it just depends, yeah. We tried doing a metal set from Campaign Coins, but it was super slidey. You couldn't get the stacks to sit nicely.
Sense.
So if you
that
do a metal version, I'd recommend roughing up the finish a little bit so it actually does the thing.
I don't know. What are you up to?
It's interesting how we're not playing a lot of walls right now.
I would definitely purchase an actual set before I created my own. Yeah, that's awesome. Well, I mean, the rules are for free online, right?
Yeah.
Like, when this comes out, the Kickstarter is over, but please support this game. Because, like we just talked about, it's only three people at Cheap Ass Games. So.
Which we appreciate, but we also, how Cheap Ass Games got our start is we did those, like, $3 to $5 games in the white envelopes.
Oh.
So we really want everybody to be able to enjoy it. So if you can manage it, we love the support, definitely. But if you just want to make your own, then by all means do that.
Company is just nothing but passionate game people.
Yeah.
You, Carol, and James are just in love with the hobby. So.
We're our own dysfunctional.
What are you doing? What's happening? Oh, gosh.
I don't know what's happening. I'm just talking to the chat room here. They're my friends. They're my friends.
Hey, chat, where should I go?
I think Malika's going to crush you eventually.
What should I do here?
I feel like I'm on defense right now. That's the interesting part about this game as I played it too is there's almost at times you're playing defense.
Subscribing NLR for 4 months.
Wait, now we're at, I've lost count. Chat, was it 25 months?
Four months in a row.
I know, but that's a total of 25
months. Yeah, but you're adding.
Woo! Anidar, you're the best.
Thank you for resubscribing. You are awesome, and you allow us to continue to
invite. We should have a Rabbit Stew Tuesday goal for months. Total months.
Total months of people who
can we get to, like, I don't know, 30 months? We're at 25? Five more months for the resubscribe?
Does it work like that? I don't think it works like that.
It doesn't?
We're kind of running out of time. Is it my turn?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
So, if I might suggest.
Hey.
Then you only have.
Stop! Oh, I forgot you could do it that way.
Yay!
No way, hey!
That was kind of like I was unclear of the strategy.
The whole, like, dropping is the...
Yeah, the dropping. But you have an announcement. You have brought something to give away.
Oh, freebies for chat.
Freebies
for
chat.
So I don't have it here, but we released three games recently, Deadfall, Before I Kill You, Mr. Spy, and the 19 and a half anniversary edition of Kill Dr. Lucky.
Kill Dr. Lucky.
So... It's super shiny.
Cheap ass game.
So one of your subscribers will win a shiny coin and a signed copy of the game, which we
will
have. Signed copy of the game. Are we ready to do I think we're gonna do a giveaway right now, right?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, let's do the giveaway right now. Be active in the chat.
Be active in chat. Ask for freebies.
Yay, freebies.
Ask and you shall receive.
Kill Dr. Lucky is a great
game. It is a great game.
We need hype. Where is the hype? Come on, chat. I want to see some hype.
Some beautiful stuff from people. Oh my god, I want a signed copy.
Oh, by the way, I have to mention, if you have not played Pairs by Cheap Ass Games, it's not a game, it's a family of games. I love Pairs.
Also for free on the website.
Hype! Hi. Campaign Coins is right.
I love the little shark.
More hype.
We need more. Give me the love.
To recap, what are we giving it away? We're giving away
a coin and a signed copy of the game.
Signed
copy of Talk?
Yeah. Oh no, of Kill Dr. Lucky.
Yeah, that's
of Kill
right
Dr. Lucky.
Kill Dr. Lucky.
Is a new edition, right?
Yeah.
Cleaned up edition.
Yay, congrats! Kitten Mare. Kitten Mare?
Kitten Mare.
Kitting Mare?
Congrats, that guy.
Cats happen.
Yay.
No, it's like Kitting
Mare. Oh, Kitting Mare. All right.
Oh, well, congratulations.
Woo! Congratulations. Free copy of Kill Dr. Lucky signed and a campaign coin that looks so good.
These are beautiful.
Thank you,
they
campaign
are
coins.
Beautiful. Thank you so much. Thanks for coming on,
Cassie. Yeah, thanks for having me.
That is so great. And Tack is so good.
Yep, it'll be out in November in local game stores.
And then we have Grab Bag. You do not want to, just listen, if you're not convinced, wait until she opens the bag to see how good for Grab Bag.
Oh my goodness, today we got blow up boobies, blow up cod pieces, we got big umbrellas, small umbrellas.
Just wait till she opens
the bag. We got dangly things that hang
spoilers
off of your head.
I was trying to, you know what a teaser is? Don't give them all
Well, you know, they need to know why they need to come.
Show up for Grab Bag. It's going
to
be amazing.
Absolutely. And I have yet to see if Fist Bumps or Hugs has won.
Oh, yeah. I'm hoping for Fist Bumps.
I'm hoping for hugs.
Malika's leaving me hanging here. She's leaving me hanging. Hey, I can do a crossover Fist Bump.
All right.
Let's do it. Oh. Yes! All right.
All right. Cool.
Bye, everybody.
Bye. Apparently Fist Bumps won.